2 laps in Moto3. The Grand Prix of Spain is underway. It was a really good start from pole position by Tatsuki Suzuki, number 24, as they roar up the hill then into turn one.
John McPhee's not had a great start. He's lost a couple of places already as they hit the brakes into the Pedrosa corner, turn six for the first time.
Oh, outside! McPhee's gone down. Oh, that's a big outside. He's lucky not to have been collected by the rest of the pack.
And that is another disaster. It's now going to be no points in four Grand Prix for John McPhee. Already, you've got to feel like that's it. Game over for his championship challenge. McPhee, a huge outside out of turn seven. This is where it goes horribly wrong. Coming through turn number seven. Oh, big, big slide on that rear tyre. You can see him scatter the pack behind him. Look how far he's gone down the circuit. Daniel Rodrigo trying to pick up some slipstream here under the flying saucer. Can he fly through on Suzuki into first place? You bet he can. On the inside, on the brakes into the first corner. Rodrigo's been brilliant at the start of this Grand Prix. Started fourth, was aggressive off the line, and now he leads. Oh, that's a huge, huge high side for him as well.
Cartwheeling.
This is going to be painful to watch.
Ouch, ouch, ouch.
Oh, dearie
me. The front tucked initially.
The front tucked, and then the rears come round at him, and this is going to be... Ow. Oh. Ejector seat well and truly engaged for Gabby Rodrigo. This is going to be a massive clattering on the back of his head. Look at that. Airbag goes off.
Out front then, it's three Red Bull KTMs in the top three. Anju, Acosta and Mattia
blitz away from that pack quite easily.
Anju went up the inside of Acosta into turn five. He's not afraid, is he, Dennis Anju? They're having a good look at each other as well. Down the back straight they go. Fanati's going to try and pick them all off while they're sleeping. And he does. He goes through to lead here in Jerez.
There's some good slipstream here being picked up by Pedro Acosta. And he just sweeps up the inside of Fanati on the brakes of the first corner. Acosta back at the front, now with six to go.
Finati's like, no, you don't. No, you do not. Up the inside he goes again. Look at Anju. Wow. What a move. I mean, he's gone way too hot in there. Relax.
I don't think so.
Are you having a laugh?
I don't think so. 2.5 laps to go, and it's anybody's in this lead group. Do not rule out Jason Tasca's coming into the top six. There he is on the blue Prustal KTM. Outstanding job by the Swiss teenager.
Acosta almost high sides out of the race on the exit of turn six, but he stays on board. Last lap here in Spain, up to turn one we go. Dennis Anju on the brink. Acosta though, lunges up the inside, block pass on the lot, and he leads.
Oh, how did he get that bike stopped? There was almost contact there on the exit as well between Mattia and Anju. Anju was desperate to hold the lead coming out of six, but he got in a little bit hot. Acosta somehow pulled that KTM up, and he made up two places, and he's on for yet another famous, famous win. Red Bull and KTM hearts will be in mouths now. There's so much at stake here. It's going to be Pedro Acosta. He tries on a tight line. Here comes Anju on the inside. Acosta's defense.
Anju's knocked him down.
They've all gone down. Binder's down. Massey is down.
And Pedro Acosta
is going to win. Three on the spin. Do not discount Pedro Acosta. He's been brilliant. When he's needed ice cool nerves on those last laps, he's found it in the first three Grand Prix. At the moment, he is on course for history. No rider, as you mentioned, ever in Grand Prix history since 1949 has started their career with four straight podiums.
Here he goes, he makes history! Acosta wins!
It is Pedro Acosta, a history maker, the golden boy of the Moto3 World Championship, the golden boy of MotoGP right now. Three wins on the trot for him. What about this young man? Pedro Acosta, take a bow. He is your history-making superstar sensation in Grand Prix racing right now. 1949, as we mentioned, in the history of Grand Prix racing, no rider had ever, ever taken four podiums in their first four Grand Prix. Not only has he done that, he's done it with three wins on a trot. What a way to celebrate that as well, with some spectacular wheelie. Absolutely incredible. What an unbelievable race here in Red.
Hi guys, if you like this video, give a thumbs up.